This is, well, this was the first one. Actually, we've done three and all, haven't you? Now, so this was this was the first one, together. And then we had Together Again.
Yeah. And the looks get more steely, don't they?
Yeah.
We've got a beard for that one. Until, and then here we are to Back Together.
Back Together. Creative genius for the titles, I think. The focus groups, the attention.
Really, yeah.
You've got a good one for...
Well, for number four, Together Forever.
That's actually
however,
really, it's just not going to happen.
he's acting now.
Guess what? We've been a bit naughty.
What?
We've come up with some of our own structure. Is that right?
Still together.
Still together. We like that one.
Yeah.
How about this one? Stop. should they still be together?
Definitely Merry Christmas, Al.
I love that one. That's my favourite.
Yeah.
Well, because that's so true to life.
Sadly, it is.
Don't be shy with your suggestions of togetherness as we go through the program as well. But obviously, you've done so much music together. So, what tracks have you chosen for this one then? And what's the kind of
we're kicking off with, and we're going to sing it tonight, is The Greatest Show from The Greatest Showman, which is one of the best modern scores of all time.
Yeah. Amazing it took so long to get off the ground when you think of the quality of the music.
Yeah. And how good the film is as well. But it's almost like Les Mis, you know. It was panned by critics, but then people came and saw it and went, you know, it's a great show.
Yeah.
Other tracks. What else have we got on there?
Sunrise, Sunset.
Sunrise, Sunset.
I love that.
Well.
Fiddler on the Roof.
Yeah. We've got a Queen medley as well, which is pretty cool. There's lots of... that's... it's made up of songs that aren't necessarily done that much, the Queen repertoire, but they're really beautiful and they go well together.
They mixed it up, really.
How do you decide who's going to do what bits?
The arm wrestle.
Do we take it, I think, actually? Is there a bit of competitiveness with who's singing what?
No, not at all.
No. I mean, because this is the third album, we've done so many gigs together, we understand each other's strengths.
Yeah.
And we want to make each other be as good as possible. Yeah. And this one was easier than the other two. We just came in and went, this will work, this won't. You sit around a piano, you sing, and you go, well, we were wrong about that, but we were right about this. And then it comes together.
Well, who chooses the video locations?
I wanted to go to Rill.
This is all done on green screen. This is in Burnley.
It was fantastic. And the bad thing was, it was the first week of rehearsals for Les Mis, and we had to miss it because we were down in the south of France. We were really popular with the rest of the company.
But you're off again. I mean, you're going to be on tour, aren't you? And you're doing arenas.
Yeah.
Man. I mean, feeling for you guys singing there, transferring from theatres, obviously, to huge arenas, which
it's fab. We did it 2 years ago, and I think, genuinely, I don't know about for you, but when the two of us went out there, especially the last gig, which was the O2, which has a kind of iconic feel to it, and you've got a full house, and they're all up in singing. It was amazing.
Yeah.
So they forced us to do it again.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Twisting your arms.
Giving, that's all we know.
But obviously you say that they're massive gigs.
Yeah.
But do you have any pre-show rituals where it helps you relax, where it gets you in the zone?
Michael never has any pre-show rituals.
I'm the worst. He does nothing.
You're on, Michael, you're on!
He's just stood back here behind those boards over there and he says, love you.
That's what we have to say back. And what do you say back?
Love you too.
And I won't say the next thing I always say to her, which is don't be. I have to. The last thing that has to be said to me before I go on stage is,
You're smelling nice for the ladies and the gentlemen.
And I have to then smell nice for the ladies and the gentlemen.
Smell nice tonight.
Thank you very much.
You borrowed mine. It's called Febreze.
You know, the team earlier on dug out some reviews from Kismet, I think it was earlier on. I didn't think it was very fair to show these, but they said it'll be funny, so...
it probably...
Yeah, I mean...
Well, the show was the funniest thing.
Was it?
It was the worst show in the history of the world.
I liked it.
Yeah. I mean, it was a shocker.
Well, the Guardian
didn't like it, did they? No one liked it. We didn't like it.
This new version is built around an irredeemably vulgar performance from Michael Hall.
You could never have a
King Alfie Ball sounds
almost like an opera singer.
This is the thing, when you've got a relationship that's kind of born on foundations like that, sticking together and going through it. Yeah. Brilliant. Love it. Anyway, the album, Back Together, or whatever kind of together you want to call it. And also the tickets for the UK Arena Tour, which starts February, isn't it?
February.
So have a look and get yourself some tickets. Great Christmas present.
Now, shortly, we'll be talking to award-winning